I'm Ivan Zoot for Jatai Academy, JATAI.net on the web. You've come to know Jatai Academy as a source for ongoing education and information in the barbering, beauty, haircutting industry. We post a ton of great stuff, whether it's from myself or a whole host of other talented beauty industry professionals. In today's video, I wanted to take a moment to explore haircutting angles. Haircutting angles and lines relative to the client, relative to the floor, and relative to outer space around the head. And the angle discussion can get pretty complicated. And at this point, I do want to make a quick acknowledgement of a good friend, Kim Moore, who is the individual responsible for developing the haircutting system called Head Shape Matters. Now, if Kim watches this video, I know she's going to cringe a little bit because I'm going to go back to some of my original education and training as it relates to things like using the phrase 90 degrees of elevation or projection or 45 degrees of elevation or projection. And one of the big takeaways from Kim, and I would not attempt under any circumstances to teach her program, nor would I attempt under any circumstances to fully understand her program, but one of the most important elements of her program is head shape matters, and where you are on the head is different on different people, whether the back of the head is more flat or more curvilinear. That being said, the information I hope to provide is going to be fairly generic to the business of building haircut shapes, acknowledging Kim's contribution to the conversation and recognizing her as the guru of this stuff. So big shout out to my friend Kim, recognizing she's got some great stuff. I'm going to share with you what I know. I'm going to do a little bit of haircutting. I've got my new Zoot comb, which I'm excited to use, and I'm going to be using my Feather Switchblade 5.5 scissors. I went old school and classic for this video. You know, Feather Switchblades have been out there a long, long time. My first one, and the handle's original, but the blades are not, and that's the beauty of switchblades, because you simply throw away the blades. I bought my first pair of switchblades. We're coming up on the 30th anniversary. When I first got into the professional beauty industry a long, long time ago, when I worked for a chain that promoted this as their scissor of choice. This particular chain loved big combs and small scissors. And when I went through their training program, I was told by a trainer, get yourself a Feather Switchblade 5.5, which I have done. Along the way over the years, at one point I upgraded. Now this is an oldie and a goodie and a collectible. They're no longer available. I'm not teasing you with it because you can't buy it, but this was called a Feather EX 5.5. I love this little scissors. It's small. It's got a wonderful offset handle, and it had a blade different from the standard switchblade. It was a more premium tool. You'll notice it has the tension adjustment screw and the spring tension plate on the top. It's got a little more of an offset to it than the 5.5 original switchblade had. It was really a goodie. I cut a lot of haircuts. I broke Guinness World Records cutting hair with this little scissors right here. As a matter of fact, one of them was mounted on a plaque and sent to the Feather factory in Japan where it lives and where I hope to go visit it one day. But in the meantime, let's talk about angles. Zero elevation is what we refer to when we're holding the hair in what I was taught was called natural fall, or the position affected by gravity. When the hair is coming straight down and we are cutting straight across, this is zero elevation. The question becomes zero relative to what? Now, I don't think looking at head shape is really the critical issue here, but enough to know that anytime we project out from the head, it is greater than zero. Many of us were taught, and I'm just going to take a section here to work, and I'm going to clip some hair up and out of the way. Throw a clipper guy gripper in there. When we project out from the head, we were told that this, like that, was a 45 degree angle. Again, the question becomes 45 to what, but it's more important to discuss what that 45 does. When we create a guide at zero and cut to that guide, and then we take a section relative to that guide and we elevate it to any degree above zero, we're going to begin to do what we call graduating. Graduating is a stacked effect in the ends of the hair. When I learned this in cosmetology school, the way I remembered it was when you graduate and you march across the stage, All the diplomas are stacked up on the table. Therefore, graduation is a stacked effect in the hair, where the ends of the hair stack up. Think about a classic wedge or a bob with a stacked back to it. You achieve that by projecting out. The higher the graduation, the higher the angle, the greater degree of stacking you will achieve through the perimeter of a haircut. Now, by definition, graduation can only appear in the perimeter of a haircut. The perimeter of a haircut, what I was taught, and again, language varies from school to school and from educational system to educational system, I was taught that the head is divided into two zones. We called it interior and exterior. Some call it the perimeter and the inside. There's a lot of different languages, but it's divided by the occipital bone, the parietal ridge, the crest line, or the widest point of the head. Anything happening below the crest line is either going to be solid, meaning zero elevation, which means considerable weight. The accumulation of hair at a given point is what we refer to as weight in the haircutting business, where the ends of the hair stack up down here at the bottom. We'd call that weight, heaviness in a haircut. But as we elevate, changing our angle, we create graduation, which is a stacking effect, which is a reduction in weight, all happening through the perimeter. But when we cross north of the occipital bone, if I project this out, as soon as I get to here, and that will be 90 degrees from the back of the head, straight out from the back of the head, 90 degrees. By the way, this at the top of the head, straight out off the top of the head, is also 90 degrees perpendicular to the surface from which it's coming. That may be confusing to some people because you just heard me say this is 90 degrees and you just heard me say this is 90 degrees. It's relative to the point from which you are measuring it, and that is the key to haircutting and certainly the key to Kim's position with Head Shape Matters as we encounter different curved surfaces and flat surfaces around the head. So when we graduate, when we get to 90, which was my point, here, anything north of 90, we are no longer graduating. Anything north of 90, we are now layering. That's right, I heard you say it, and I know you knew where I was going with that. We're now layering. So anytime we're working over the top of the head, we are going to be creating layers in the hair. Layering is defined as a progression of lengths. Now there's two different forms of layering. There is what's called uniform layering. I've heard people call it consistent layering or even layering, where essentially what we're looking to do is create all hairs the same length. Think about if he was struck by lightning, zap, or put his finger in a socket, zap, and all the hair was sticking straight out of the head and it was all the same length. The shape of the haircut, the silhouette of the haircut, would mimic the shape of the head. And if every hair is the same length, that is frequently cut using with what we call a traveling guide. That would be where you took a guide at the top of the head, you cut that guide to the desired length just like that. I'm just going to cut that piece right there. And then when you took the next section, you would take that guide, split it in half, move over, and you would take the two together. Now notice, I'm not coming back up to 90 at the top. I'm coming 90 from where it lives, straight out off the top of the head. Now that's still 90, not 90 relative to top dead center, but 90 relative to where it lives. So I come out to here, I look for that previously cut section in my fingers to serve as my guide, and I will cut to match. For my next section, I'd move down, I'd move over, I'd take the next section, and notice, if I drag this all the way back to the top, it's going to get longer, and the layers are going to be longer. But if I drag it out 90, perpendicular to where it grows out of the head, and I cut it, I'm going to be creating a uniform length like that. The principle in haircutting here, which is so fundamental, is length increases opposite the cutting point. I've used this and demonstrated this very vividly in videos I have that talk about fringe cutting. Frequently, we will have situations in which we'll be cutting the fringe, some people will call it the bangs, on a haircut, and somebody will say, I want my fringe to sweep to one side. I want it longer over there. If you want it longer on the client's left, I will instruct you to move it to the client's right. Notice from where my fingers are, this piece of hair is shorter than this piece of hair that travels a greater distance to get there. So if I cut that here, and then I wear it there, it's gonna be longer flowing that way. That's some basic information on angles and positioning around the head with hair cutting. You can apply this information to the great hair cutting work that you do. I'm curious to know what your questions and comments on the subject of lines and angles are, and I'm happy to help. JATAI.net on the web is Jatai Academy. I'm Ivan Zoot, I am Clipper Guy. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.